హాయ్ కృష్ణ ముఖర్జీ గారు.
హాయ్ అనూష.
సో హౌ ఆర్ యూ డూయింగ్?
ఐ ఆమ్ ఎక్స్టాటిక్, నర్వస్, ఫిల్డ్ విత్ బటర్ఫ్లైస్ ఇన్ మై స్టమక్. ఐఎమ్ ఆల్ ఆఫ్ దాట్.
సో హౌ ఇస్ టాలీవుడ్?
టాలీవుడ్ హెస్ బీన్ రియలీ రియలీ కైండ్ టు మీ. అండ్ ఐ డోంట్ నో, ఐమ్ జస్ట్ ట్రూలీ హంబల్డ్ టు find my director producer definitely about 3 years back, and right now the people who are supporting our film, like Mahesh Konaru sir and Harish Shankar sir, for his support and everything, and for Mahesh Konaru sir to, you know, produce and distribute the film, you know, sort of distribute the film in theaters and everything, to make it get there, and for the people that we love so much, which is our audience, for them to see our hard work. So yeah, I'm excited. I'm super excited. It's been really kind. Thank you very much. I mean, I'm truly thankful to Tollywood over here.
So ఒకసారి మా ఆడియన్స్ మీ గురించి తెలుసుకోవడానికి, అంటే బిఫోర్ మదా, వాట్ వాజ్ యువర్ జర్నీ?
సో ఇట్ వాజ్ అ లాంగ్ జర్నీ, బట్ సో బేసిక్లీ ఐ స్టార్టెడ్ యాజ్ అ సింగర్ ఇన్ ద ఇండస్ట్రీ, బట్ దాట్ వాజ్ ఇన్ బెంగాలీ. ఐ స్టార్టెడ్ సింగింగ్.
Yes,
I used to sing, and I started with Saregamapa, and then Zee picked me up and they said, you know, why don't you do this show? We need a vocalist as well. And from there on began my acting journey. Initially, I didn't like it much. My target was that, you know, they said, if you, you know, we can get you to sing the theme song of this particular show. But we also need you as a vocalist. And I was thinking, you know, I'll just sing my theme song and I'll just get out of the show and whatnot. But by the time it came down to the recording bit of the theme song, which was the playback version that I was given, I was passionately in love with acting as a profession. Mm. So, yeah, so that's how it started. And then I don't typically look Bengali, so it got a little difficult to, you know, change characters in Bengal. Mm. But eventually, me and my family decided that it's time for me to move to Mumbai. And we came to Mumbai, and boy, did I do some really, really different characters. I did South Indian woman, Rajasthani woman, I did Gujarati, you know, modern, ethnic, all of it, like high class, low class, all of it that I could possibly expect to play as an artist. I played all of it with different kinds of stories and different kinds of situations. So, yeah, so it started out with episodics, which I almost, in my own head, I treated them like films. And eventually, I came here and I did my first Telugu film. And then after that, I went back and then I started demanding to do something different all the time. And then eventually, now I've been doing web series. I've completed 3 with Alt Balaji.
Okay. Ekta Kapoor, yeah. One, right? Okay, 3 web series. Okay. Nice. So, how did this offer came to you? Mada movie, avakasam meeku ela vachindi asalu?
It came very suddenly, really. I was thinking of doing something different, yes, but and I had some people who were fans of the show that I used to do called Crime Patrol, and I used to get fans from, you know, from here, from from Kerala, from Chennai. I used to get fans from everywhere sending me messages and all of that. And needless to say that, you know, the messenger bit of my Facebook used to be almost covered with fan messages and fan mails. Now, I used to try and respond to most of them, but the important messages which come after that, you know, then they just, you know, end up going into spam, because my friends list is blocked out and my, you know, messenger list is also blocked out. So one fine day, I just decided to, you know, just go through the spam messages which came, as in the other messages which come on Messenger. And I find a name which I was like, okay, he's like, hi, Trishna. Needed to talk to you regarding some work. That was the first, the notifications which come, that is the notification. I said, needed to talk to you. Like, everybody is telling, you know, we like your work, we are fans and this and that. But this time it was like a little different, because it started with, hi, Trishna, and then brrr, all work. So I was like, okay, I like the approach, because I'm a blunt person myself, and I really liked her approach. And then I, you know, patched her through to my team that were overlooking the process, and me and my manager, we looked at each other and we decided, you know, boom, we are going to do this film. That's it, no questions asked.
Okay. Okay.
And it just happened. Like, I think the stars aligned at that point of time. I was looking to do something different. This seemed different. The script was amazing. And it just totally happened. And I have Indira aunty and Vidya to thank for that, yeah.
ఇంకా మూవీ ఇంకా రిలీజ్ అవ్వకముందే, అఫ్ కోర్స్ మనకి ఇంకో కపుల్ ఆఫ్ డేస్లో రిలీజ్ ఉంది మధా మూవీ. సో రిలీజ్కి ముందే 26 అవార్డ్స్ బ్యాక్ చేయడం అన్నది ఇట్స్ అ గ్రేట్ థింగ్. మీకు కూడా ఒక 3 అవార్డ్స్ వచ్చాయి యాజ్ అ బెస్ట్ యాక్ట్రెస్గా.
టు రియాక్ట్ టు దట్ ఐమ్ స్టిల్ యు నో ఐ టేక్ ఇట్ అస్ 26 అవార్డ్స్ నాట్ 3 బెస్ట్ యాక్టర్స్ ఐ టేక్ ఇట్ అస్ 26 అవార్డ్స్ యా
యూనిట్ థింగ్ ద హోల్ యూనిట్ థింగ్. సో అంతే అంటే అన్ని ఫిల్మ్ ఫెస్టివల్స్లో లైక్ ఆల్మోస్ట్, శ్రీ విద్యా గారు కూడా చెప్పారు ఫంక్షన్లో, లైక్ 30 ఫిలిం ఫెస్టివల్స్కి పంపిస్తే మొత్తం ఆల్మోస్ట్ లైక్ ప్రతి 26 ఫిలిం ఫెస్టివల్స్లో అవార్డ్స్ని గెలుచుకుంది. అండ్ మిగతా 3 అండ్ 4 అవి కూడా ఫైనలిస్ట్లకి వెళ్ళింది ఆ మూవీ అన్నది. సో యూనో ఇన్ని అవార్డ్స్, ఇంత అప్లాజ్ వచ్చిన ఒక మూవీలో ఒక పార్ట్ అయినందుకు ఎలా ఫీల్ అవుతున్నారు?
Of course, it feels great. No doubt about it. We worked so hard. I wouldn't say I worked hard because a lot of the times, you know, I'm a human being. I get tired. I feel traumatized when a situation is traumatic for a very long time. Like if you would notice the asylum sequences, it looks like I'm really traumatized. I was, because how do I say it? So I know it's a set, I know that it's all acting, but the situation around was a little bit too, you know, congested, and you know, there were I'm petrified of insects, I'm very scared. Okay. So there were insects around and I was actually traumatized. And then after the first day, Vidya didn't let me wash my hair for like the longest time. She's like, this schedule gets over and then you can take your head bath.
Okay.
And I'm like, are you serious? So, you know, I'm saying it's not trauma. And then I injured myself. I had to work through the injury. On the first day of the shoot, I injured myself. Oh. My back, I fell from a wall. And so, but you know, then again, like every time I sat down, there were these group of spot dadas who would make sure that, you know, like after the shot was over, they made sure that, you know, they carried the chair for me with that medicated cushion that I was recommended to sit on. They would be there, you know, like constantly holding it. I still remember those parts. And when, you know, we are shooting, they don't need to be around, but they were constantly around. When you have a team, which is, I'm obviously the people who are directly involved, the technicians, say light, camera, direction, actors, they need to be there. It's, you know, it's a requisite. But when these people who do not need to be there are still constantly tailing you, the entire team, asking what is it that you need, should we get you something, some more coffee, some more tea, some more refreshments and all that. When you have an entire team that works like that, then lack of sleep doesn't matter, lack of food doesn't matter, you know, the barrier in language doesn't matter. And by the way, when I tried to speak Telugu, because I had so many Telugu dialogues, I used to start to, you know, converse with the spot dadas in Telugu, and they used to have so much fun making fun of me that it was a whole family-like situation during the set. So of course it felt great, but it also felt great for the entire team, because all that effort, all that struggle that we all went through, belief aside, you know, that struggle was also paid off. Like, you know, that's what meant, you know, that's the reason I don't like to take credit for the 3 best actors that I got, actresses, but I'd rather take it as the 26 awards for the team. It's all for the team. Yeah.
Nice. And how was it working with Sri Vidya Baswagaru, the director of the film Madha?
It was amazing. Firstly, Sri Vidya and I are both very similar in nature. We are blunt. We talk direct. During the trailer launch, she did say this, that, you know, she doesn't get along so well with women. It's not true. She actually gets along with everybody. I think the thing with us is, you know, we need the approach to be really direct and really honest and really positive. I think that's where she gets along with everybody on the set. And with Vidya and I, the thing is, we are both workaholics. We both take our work extremely seriously. And by extremely seriously, I mean, if there's a shot which is incomplete, we'd rather not eat and finish that shot. you know. So for us, it's been like that. We'd rather not sleep. So for me, it was amazing. Plus, every request that I made as an actor at the very onset, you don't know what you're going to come into. Like, of course, I've been in Telangana for a while. I studied here for a bit, but I've never stayed outside of my own independent zone. And over here, I'm like a, you know, I'm at their disposal. What they need me to do, I'm doing that, and you know, things like that. So in that, to give me absolutely 100% and more of dignity was something that completely stole my heart. So yeah, it was awesome, and I will continue working with Vidya whenever she needs me to work with her. And of course, Indira aunty, to we got to know each other as family. We have not met personally, but we are definitely family even otherwise. Yeah.
Okay. అండ్ శ్రీవిద్య గారి గురించి మాట్లాడుకుంటే, ఒక లేడీ డైరెక్టర్గా మీకేమన్నా ఇంకా ఎక్కువ కంఫర్ట్ అనిపించిందా?
యా, దేర్ ఇస్ ఆబ్వియస్లీ లిటిల్ కంఫర్ట్ వెన్ అ డైరెక్టర్ ఇస్ ఫీమేల్ ఫర్ మీ పర్సే, బికాస్ యూ నో లైక్ సెవరల్ టైమ్స్ లైక్ ఐ వాజ్ జస్ట్ ఇన్ అ గౌన్, లైక్ ఫర్ మోస్ట్ పార్ట్ ఆఫ్ ద ఫిల్మ్ ఐమ్ ఇన్ అ గౌన్, అండ్ సెవరల్ టైమ్స్ దేర్ ఆర్ అండ్ you know, the technicians, many of them being male, there were times, you know, when we would shoot in a certain sequence and be in a certain sequence where maybe I'm not completely appropriately sitting or standing or whatever. So at that point of time, having a female director, because she is, you know, monitoring every frame, it always helps, because before anyone can come and point it out, she's already noticing it and she's already coming, because I am literally mad when I'm shooting. I'm literally mad. So I have no idea where my gown is going and what is showing and what is not showing. And she had that, you know, as a visual, she had that audience like look from the monitor, and she would come and inform me of the same things. And, you know, of course, that definitely helps. That bit of, as you know, performance really helps. Also, the fact that although we are female directors, you know, most of what we gel with are like the dudes on the set, actually. We are as much bros to them as they are to us. So, but nonetheless, having that attitude and being a female, I think pushes both of us to totally achieve what we want to achieve. And it makes us really strong and bold in our day-to-day life. And by bold, I don't mean like a bold actor who is doing a bold sequence. No, I mean like bold in attitude. We chase what we want to go after, and we chase it till we hunt that destination down and we get it. We both have that go-getting attitude. I think a little bit of that comes from the strength of actually being a woman, and also the fact that we are surrounded by so many extremely achieving males around us. So they are definitely an inspiration. We are standing out over here because we are women, but the males are definitely an inspiration for us, because I'm also surrounded by most of my guy friends around in Mumbai or here. So they really inspire me. So if I'm to talk for Vidya as a female director, I think that's what I would like to point out, that working with a female director has its advantages. And I'm used to, you know, get together like after the shoots also, we would, you know, discuss so many different stories and stories in my head, stories in her head. And yeah, I think that's what, you know, was the added advantage of being a female director that I had actually as an actor. Yeah.
So trailer lo me character lo maaku chala shades kanipinchayi by watching the trailer. So inka emanna shades undabothunnaya movie lo? So me characterization gurinchi, me character gurinchi cheppalante em cheptaru movie lo?
If I have to character is, you know, your very normal day to day simple vulnerable girl, you know, someone who believes in the world, believes in people around her. It doesn't, you know, like those kind of people who it doesn't take like 2 seconds to believe them. That aspect of my personality is very similar with Nisha. And but there are some people who overdo it at times. And since it's cinema, we have to show the extreme aspect. Otherwise, it won't make the story. So Nisha would be one of those characters who totally believes in people around her and, you know, you know, her surroundings, and she has a lot of faith in people. And how, when the situation of those people change, you know, things drastically change with Nisha as well. So it was interesting working on that kind of a character because I'm not that vulnerable. I'm vulnerable, I trust people, but I'm not that vulnerable. I like to think of myself as someone who is extremely strong. Even if I'm hurt and my vulnerability is taken advantage of, I don't show it easy. But Nisha shows. She shows it, and that's what makes the film. Also the fact that, you know, when she's going through these various different scenarios, you get to really actually question that, you know, all this is happening, but is this what Nisha really is? And that, my friend, is what the story is about. So I don't want to divulge too much because I get so excited speaking about Nisha that she's this, but she's not. She's that and that, then she's not. So I read a few comments after the trailer was launched yesterday, and someone apparently told, you know, that everything has been revealed in the trailer, but has it? Not.
No. Yeah, trailer ni chuste nijanga anni andulo reveal ayinatte kanipistundi, but em reveal avvaledantaru.
Obviously not. Yeah, it's a trailer. Of course, you're not revealing everything. Otherwise, who's going to go and watch the film?
Yeah, and a trailer ala cut chesaru antunnanu.
Yeah, the feel of the trailer itself is. So basically, the whole idea of the film itself is, you know, that you may think you know everything, and that is what you know, what you end up feeling during the film as well. That you may think that you know everything, but do you? You may feel, you know, you may think that you know, and like even as Nisha, if I'm to say, Nisha feels that, you know, okay, fine, so I know this, you know, I'm sure, you know, this is what, everything is going to be fine, but is it actually becoming fine? You know, and some of that is revealed in the trailer. Also, when we are cutting the theatrical trailer, the idea itself was that, you know, the audience may feel, and that is what Nisha feels through the entire film, that, you know, I know everything, you know. Yeah, everything is going to be fine. You know, everything, he's a good guy. But is it, you know? And the same thing is what I thought, you know, it's going to be really, it's very metaphorical because, you know, you think you've seen all in the trailer, but have you?
Okay.
That's a good question, right?
So, me life lo, ipparadaka shooting paranga kavachu, leda personal life paranga kavachu, meeru face chesina biggest hurdle enti, and danni ela overcome chesaru?
So my biggest hurdle at started, like that one point was I was very, very new in Mumbai. I didn't know anyone much, and I had just shifted from. So a few of my friends helped me put up in their house for the first couple of days, and after I shifted out, I was on my own, and I wanted my parents to be proud of who I am and everything. But you know, making a career is not like a matter of overnight, or it doesn't happen overnight. So I was working through some shows and stuff, and I came across these few production houses. They promised something and they didn't deliver, you know, unlike we deliver. So I came across a point for about 8 days, and this was just before Crime Patrol. I had just done my first episode there, and I was really in need of the checks which was supposed to be given to me. The amount was not much, but enough to make my rent and, you know, get me some food and whatnot. And these guys were just not giving it. So I didn't have anything that time. And I was too, you know, my self-respect was hurting because I came to Bombay with, you know, some of my mother's savings, and, you know, I didn't want to ask her for more. And I was like, you know, I'll do this on my own. I can manage it. And I kept on telling that to myself. And eventually it just so happened that I came down to 400 bucks in my account. I didn't have anything more.
Okay.
And in that, I have to go to the production house, come back, see if they have given, you know, have my check ready and all of that. I went for 8 days without eating a bite.
8 days?
8 days. I had this guy who owns a dairy shop. And he and I, you know, sort of, he was kind enough to me to give me like a packet of milk every day worth of 20 bucks at that time. And I would have half of it in the morning, half of it in the evening.
Drinking only milk?
Morning and evening, yeah. And that fills you up. Trust me, that does. When the situation is bad, that fills you up. So I hadn't expected that because I had, you know, that phase is something I hadn't expected would happen to me. Because in Calcutta, I have a home. I don't have rent. I have my parents to shelter me. And I was doing shows and all, but I was never, you know, I was like, you know what, I'll wait for the right character to come along. I don't have to, you know, do this and do that and, you know, be very arrogant and all that. But eventually what happened was that I realized that I was so ungrateful to what I had, that is my parents' home, and you know, the fact that, you know, anytime I need to get from one place to another, I had a mode of accommodation, which is my car and all of those things, which I didn't have in Bombay now.
మీరు ఇంట్లో వాళ్ళని ఎందుకు అడగకూడదు అనుకున్నారంటే, ఆఫ్ కోర్స్ ఐ నో, మనకు మనం బయటకు వచ్చిన తర్వాత డెఫినెట్లీ మనం ఇంట్లో వాళ్ళ మీద డిపెండ్ అయ్యి ఉండాలని అనుకోము. బట్ ఇన్ దట్ సిచ్యువేషన్ అంటే మీ బ్యాంక్ అకౌంట్లో జస్ట్ 400 ఉండి ఈవెన్ అది కూడా అయిపోయి, ఐ మీన్ ఫుడ్కి కూడా మీరు 8 డేస్ స్ట్రగుల్ చేసి అలా ఉన్నప్పుడు.
బట్ బికాస్ దట్ ఈస్ బికాస్ అనదర్ గాయ్ హూ ఐ రిక్వెస్టెడ్ యునో టు హ్యాండ్ ఓవర్ మై అమౌంట్ క్విక్లీ డెలివర్డ్, అదర్వైజ్ ఇట్ వుడ్ హావ్ బీన్ మోర్. బట్ థ్యాంక్ఫుల్లీ హీ డెలివర్డ్. I couldn't, for I think a good 6-7 days I even refused to talk to them. They would call and I would say, no, I'm busy, I don't want, you know, I'm going here, I'm going there and all that, but it was not true. I used to travel by foot like 7-8 kilometers to the production.
That was the worst situation.
That is probably physically the worst situation I've been in, not emotionally though, because I knew that I'm going to get my thing out, you know, and I'm very, like I said, I'm very strong that way, and I don't express my vulnerability unless it has passed. I need to deal with a situation myself to, you know. So that was at the beginning, like about 7 years back that happened. And
at the time, what was the amount?
The amount that I was going to get? 40,000.
Okay.
But I did another small work and I got some more money out of that. So these guys, the smaller amount guys, they delivered like, I think, about 15-20,000 at best.
Okay.
So they delivered really quickly, and that day I had like, you know, I had like so much food, it was unbelievable. Like, I didn't know I had that kind of an appetite, but I did, and I just finished all of it. I just downed all of it. So it was all great. That was the only one phase. Those 8 days I'll distinctly remember, because I used to travel 8 kilometers from the place where I stayed to the production house and get my, you know, inquire what is happening. I even remember I got so desperate that, you know, I yelled at them one of the days, which is absolutely not me. I'm a person with a very strong voice. I don't feel the need to yell, but I did yell at them. I was so desperate. Obviously, there was no food in my stomach and I was walking 7-8 kilometers a day. So eventually, after this check came in, these guys also delivered and delivered their check. And finally, you know, I was like, okay, fine, my... So I valued what little I had at that point of time, the fact that I had a roof over my head and all of those things.
But మనకి ఎప్పుడైనా ఇలాంటి విషయాల్లో కోపం వస్తుందా అంటే, see, మనం ఎక్కడన్నా బయట జాబ్ చేసినప్పుడు మనకి ఫస్ట్ కి ఆర్ యునో సమ్ వాళ్ళ కంపెనీ ఫిక్స్ చేసుకున్న డేట్స్ కి మనకి ఆ సాలరీ అనేది ఆటోమేటికల్లీ అకౌంట్స్ లో క్రెడిట్ అయిపోతూ ఉంటుంది. బట్ ఇక్కడ వెన్ వీ వర్క్ అందులోనూ మనకు పర్టికులర్ ఇన్ని అవర్స్ అని ఉండదు. లైక్ విల్ బి వర్కింగ్ 12 hours ఏ డే, 13 hours, 14 hours, ఏదైనా సరే విల్ ఫినిష్ అవర్ వర్క్ అండ్ గో. సో అలాంటిది ద మోర్ స్ట్రెస్ వీ టేక్ అలాంటిది ఇంత చేసుకోవడం, మళ్ళీ వీ హ్యావ్ టు రిక్వెస్ట్ దెమ్ ఫర్ మనీ, వీ హ్యావ్ టు బీ ఎట్ ద బ్యాక్ ఆఫ్ దెమ్, వై, ఎందుకు అని ఎప్పుడైనా కోపం వచ్చిందో మీకు?
థింక్ అబౌట్ ద సేమ్ థింగ్ యునో, బట్ then again there are cases in our industry, whichever industry you pick, you can pick up Bangla, you can pick up Tollywood, you can pick up Bollywood, you can pick up any of the industries, there have been so many reported cases where actors have actually taken the amounts in advance and not delivered their bit of the deal. So I think it goes both way. But you know, I have also, having said this one particular incident, all the others that, you know, have delivered on time have not caused me, and have been immensely respectful to me as an actor on set. I can't discount those either. And yeah, it is difficult. I still wonder why. I think I still believe, you know, the way the payments are levied to actors should see a little bit of a development, so that nobody is left stranded midway once the work is over. But of course, little by little changes may be coming, but we are still a long way to go. I totally believe in that. And sometimes also what happens is you can't blame any one particular. Okay, so we are associating with the production house, but the production houses are also dependent on channels, and we don't know what is happening there. So it is very, you know, it's very unjust to blame them. Ho gaya, of course, that was a situation, that was a bad situation. But even after that, I worked with them, and that time they, you know, delivered bang on time, like. At the end of the, you know, the scheduled number of days, at the end of 45 days, it was already in my account and I had nothing to complain about.
Okay.
So yeah, those things also happened. That was that one and only thing, you know, probably because I was starting out and also I was not working as much. But after that, I just like constantly was working, thanks to the shows that I did and everything. So it was pretty much settled. And after that, the next struggle that I saw was, you know, when Madha was made, I was 100% confident that, you know, the film is, you know, just going to boom, because every city, every state wants to see something, you know, something of a little, you know, difference in the treatment or the performance or the direction. Or of course, direction, so they are not seeing when as a, seeing as an audience, but the treatments and the colors and the performance and the sounds, they wanted slightly different. So I had that entire confidence looking at Vidya's vision that this is what I'll get done and this is what I'll get done and this is what I'll get done. I was totally confident that, you know, anyone who sees the film will immediately want to, you know, let's go. But that initially, when it was a little difficult and that didn't happen, that was another struggle, because I was really counting on this aspect of the thing to work out. And from, and that would change how, you know, how I, you know, do my other work after that. Mm-hmm. But I like, again, like we are like, you know, horses with blinds. We just run, we don't see right and left. We just, you know, hustle. And that's what Vidya and I did. So I had faith in her. My faith, not for a single second ever felt that, you know, release hoga ki nahi, kya hoga ki nahi. I never felt that. I always knew that the film will come out, and whenever it comes out, it's going to deliver its, you know, due share. People are going to love what Vidya has made in this film. And I'm really hoping.
And what's your take on casting couch? Did you ever experienced it?
Thankfully, no. I'll tell you why. Thankfully, no. It's not like no one has attempted it on me. You know, before we get to the point where someone directly approaches you, you get hints. Okay, like I definitely do get hints. And shuru mein, and I try to behave as much, you know, normally about the whole thing. Like, you know, nobody says it to you directly, right? They say, no, come, let's go for a, you know, a coffee or whatever. And they also know the fact that you know that this is at the back of, you know, their minds. So just to, you know, turn it down politely, and thankfully I'm good with that. I generally just turn it down politely, or I, like, for example, I have very, very set rules for myself. I never meet if it's not an office, or if you want to meet me at a hotel, it's going to be the lobby. So I, these are a few rules I set for myself, and if they don't come, I'll go to the location, I'll come back, but I will never, you know, if they say, you know, I'm in a meeting in my room, why don't you come here? I'm waiting at the lobby. Finish up and I'll meet you at the lobby. I'm okay. So these are a few things I've set for myself. And also the fact that people try, not everybody's successful. And one thing for women to remember is, you know, people who are genuinely working, like who are busy, who really mean business, they don't have the time for this. They don't have the time to sit with you for a cup of coffee, wondering whether or not you're going to be leading their film. Their intentions are just totally different. So they will not be there. I mean, people who seriously work in our industry and so much good work is being churned out, they don't have the time for all this. They don't have the time. So you can just blatantly say no when someone is saying, you know, let's, you know, catch up for a coffee, let's go for a date. No. Don't be creepy now.
So, నాకు ఒకసారి మీ పాట కూడా వినాలని ఉంది. మీరు సింగర్ కాబట్టి, సో ఎనీ ఆఫ్ ఈవెన్ ఇట్స్ బెంగాలీ, వీఆర్ ఫైన్. సో ఒకసారి సింగర్, సో ఒకసారి ఒక సాంగ్.
ఓకే, సో ఐ హావెంట్ స్లెప్ట్ మచ్ ఇన్ అ ఫ్యూ డేస్, సో మై థ్రోట్ ఇస్ లిటిల్ డౌన్, బట్ ఐల్ ట్రై అండ్ హమ్ అ ఫ్యూ లైన్స్ ఫర్ యూ. Let me see, I can't actually think of a song right at the top of my head. You just took me by surprise. Okay, I'll just sing like four lines from one of my favorite English songs by Adele. I'll try. If it goes bad, please cut it. Don't keep it. Okay. I heard that you settle down, that you've found a girl and you're married now, I heard that your dreams came true. Guess she gave you things I couldn't give to you. Old friend, why you so shy? It ain't like you to hold back or hide from the light. I hate to turn up out of the blue uninvited, but I couldn't stay away. I couldn't fight it. I'd hoped you'd see my face and that you'd be reminded that for me, it isn't over. I'm going to only sing that much. If I go high, I'm going to crack. So,
no, it's very nice. Your voice is very soothing, actually. So, okay, we'll have a round about our Tollywood heroes.
Okay, I hope I can answer it well.
So, Telugu cinema chustu untara baga?
I see a little bit. After doing Madha, I started seeing a few of the movies. And also, I have seen before also, like, when you know, the Hindi dubbed version of it comes out. So, I see some of that. I kind of enjoy it.
So, villa perlu cheppagane, meeku varilo gurtochedi gaani, leda if you have some memories or incidents to share with them also, you can tell them. Chiranjeevi garu.
So I really genuinely liked him for this one sequence of dance I saw with Silk Smita. So I really enjoyed the way, you know, women are always asked to dance like a man. But he had this grace just as much as her. And back then my dad also had a mustache. So I really liked seeing men in mustaches. It was really entertaining for me. So yeah, I think that's the earliest memory of Chiranjeevi garu that I have. Yeah.
Rajana garu.
Tum mile dil khile. Oh, I was like, I've sung that song a gazillion times. The moment you tell me about Nagarjuna garu, that's the first that I come, you know, the first thing, it's like Nagarjuna garu's face is there and at the back of, you know, there's a background music. There's Tum mile dil khile playing at the back of my mind. Okay. Yeah.
Venkatesh garu.
But I definitely have seen him. He's pretty good looking, I have to say that. But as of right now, with the interview, I can't really think much of the top, from the top of my head.
Mahesh Babu garu.
I was not a part of the film industry at all at that point of time. And not just that, I had no interest whatsoever. But I used to really like this actor called Namrata Shirodkar. And one fine day I see this picture and I'm like, you know, she had just married him and they were leaving for their honeymoon or something. So that picture of them, I still remember that blow up. That's the first time I, you know, remembered him. And then in my computer, I started searching, who is this guy who took my Namrata from me? And nothing bad. Just a true fan of hers, and that's how I first came to know of Mahesh Babu. And then obviously I saw a lot of films on set TV, and the recent one that I ended up watching was Sai something with Rashmika Mandanna that he is. Yeah, that one. So that is the one that I ended up watching a little bit.
Okay.
And Good stuff.
మీరు ఎలా అయితే వెతికారో ఎవరబ్బా నమ్రత శిరోద్కర్ ని తీసుకెళ్లిపోయారు అని చెప్పి అలాగే పాపం అసలు ఈ రెండు తెలుగు రాష్ట్రాలు అమ్మాయిలందరూ అలా వెతికారు అయితే అంటే మహేష్ బాబు గారిని అసలు అమ్మాయిలకి ఇక్కడ పిచ్చ క్రేజ్ మా ఊళ్ళు క్రేజ్ కాదు ఇప్పటికీ
గర్ల్ క్రేజీ కైండ్ ఆఫ్ యాజ్ ఇన్ ద గర్ల్స్ డ్రైవ్ ద గర్ల్స్ క్రేజీ కైండ్ ఆఫ్ అ ఫేస్ యు నో లైక్ యు స్మైల్ అండ్ గర్ల్స్ గో లైక్ వూ
పవన్ కళ్యాణ్ గారు
I saw some of his films on Setmax, you know, some of the Indian, you know, Hindi channels that telecast a lot of South Indian films. And although I can't perhaps remember exactly which film I saw again, but I do remember the amazing action sequences and the swag that these guys have, which I think a lot of it, you know, is right now being... you know, the punchlines and the swag of these lead actors are being emulated back in Bollywood right now. Not right now, actually. I think it's always been there, no? Like these emulations and these punchlines and everything. So yeah, that's one amazing thing. Although I recently learned that the last Pavan Kalyan film, I think, was a remake of Dabang. Yeah?
Gabbar Singh.
Gabbar Singh, yes. So, I recently learned that. I was not aware of that. But it was, you know, it was... I was extremely proud as a member of Mumbai, that member of Bollywood, that, you know, finally one film was remade in Telugu as opposed to otherwise. I was really proud of that.
Junior NTR Garu.
See, with all of these amazing gentlemen, so, okay, so with Junior NTR Garu, I learned that they have armies. They just don't have fans. They have armies. Like, so the first name that popped up when this thing came forward in front of me was the fact that they don't have fans. They have like armies backing them, you know, like, it is amazing to, it's not particularly related to Junior NTR Garu, but I think, you know, as an actor, they must feel so humbled that, you know, the moment they step out of their home, their, you know, homes are totally flocked by all these Junior NTR army, and then there's this Mahesh army, and then this Pavan Kalyan army and all that. So I think it's very humbling. So with most of the heroes over here, I have similar experiences. Like, I have seen their Hindi dubbed version films. I, you know, saw them, you know, their expressions. And there's this one expression of Junior NTR Garu, which really I find very, I have not been able to copy it. So I have always, one of my mentors had taught me to become an actor is see the most, you know, amusing expression that you find on screen and try and replicate that on your face and see how it looks. Then you'll understand the difference between copying an actor, because you never actually end up copying an actor because your entire face and your body language is different. It just different imitations, miming and imitations. It's different imitations of the same actor, but it's never exactly copy. Nobody can exactly say, you know, that guy's exactly like Junior NTR. They can never say it because he's a different human being altogether.
What's the most thing that you love? I mean, meeku baga nache vishayam enti Junior NTR garlo? What was the, you know, most lovable thing in him?
Okay.
That in an actor, actors are so thin these days. Nobody has a face with cheeks, really. I liked that about. I like a man who has like a round face, and
okay.
I find his face really attractive.
Tarvata aina sannaga ayipoyaru kada Junior NTR garu. Starting days, you know, he used to be meer cheppinattu
chepi. I must have seen that. I haven't seen him right now.
Okay.
I haven't seen him right now. Has he lost his cheeks?
Yeah, way back.
Really?
Yeah.
Okay.
Heartbreaker.
Yeah, a little heartbroken. Yes, that's true.
Prabhas
Garu. Of course, Prabhas Garu is... Oh, that's another man with cheeks. That's another man with cheeks, yes. So, I saw Prabhas sir's Bahubali, definitely. I saw all of them. And what do I say? He's got this simplicity, which I find is... And I think, you know, South Indians have that simplicity mostly around them. I see that in most of their smiles, that, you know, there's this thing of, you know, being very humble and very simple. And I especially like Prabhas sir's smile, because when he smiles, it is like, you know, no matter how much swag he's showing, you know, the moment he smiles, it's like, oh, I'm just a simple little boy, you know. I'm just so simple, and that I really find that really charming. I think that's what you know, attracts as a fan, as a fan would attract me to Prabhas sir as a as an actor. Yeah,
Allu Arjun garu,
superb dancer, man. Fantastic dancer.
Okay,
I saw this kick-ass move that he did in a song, and I think it was choreographed also by Prabhu Deva. I think so. I'm not sure though. But some really nasty moves, man. That guy is like, what? And it's not like, you know, it's not like a rubber band, or it's not any one particular form. But it's like, you know, if I am dancing. Okay, if I'm dancing, it's terrible. But if any one of, you know, who our friends we would call as a good dancer, if they ended up doing some really kick-ass steps and doing it like... so smooth, like it's just like, you know, it's just like a balle balle or something. It's that easy, man. That guy can dance, dude. Seriously. I love that about him. I totally love that about him. It's not unrealistic. It's very realistic, but it's superb. It's graceful. It's expressive. It's sexy.
Okay.
It's really sexy. Yeah.
Ram Charan garu.
I first saw him in Zanjeer. And I find him to be really, I really like his, depictions and, the way he delivers his characters. I really end up liking that. Maybe the characters that I saw him perform in are all those serious characters and all that. But I really like the way he's able to carry that, that swag with humility yet seriousness. Like, hi, I'm Ram Charan. I'm smiling, but he would probably not even smile, but that kind. But it's that the humility is there, the swagger is there, and at the same time, he's very, very serious about the whole approach. I think I like that. That is a demeanor that I have not seen many actors in, and that is very, very appealing to me. Yeah.
Vijay Devarakonda.
Well, I saw him in Arjun Reddy. What do I say? He played it so well, I wanted to slap him at one point of time.
Yeah.
He's so good, yeah, as an actor, he's so good. And I was jealous as an actor. Like, and also the fact that the way he was, presenting himself to be this rude lover boy, I was like, man, why? Calm down, like that kind of a feel. I mean, I didn't want to slap him, of course. I meant it in the sense that, I was jealous of the way he was performing. I was like mesmerized. And of course, it shows, because then that was made into Kabir Singh later, which is amazing. I do hope to work with him though, one day, hopefully. Fingers crossed.
So, finally, thank you so much. So already Madha movie chala awards gelchukundi. Manaki March 13th movie kuda release kabothundi. I know definitely akkada kuda movie ela aithe anni awards gelchukundo anta prekshakula hrudayalu kuda gelchukoni manchi hit avvalani korukuntunnanu.
Thank you. It's my pleasure.
Please like, follow and subscribe.
Please subscribe.
Please subscribe.
Please subscribe.
Please subscribe.
Subscribe.
Please subscribe.
Please subscribe.
Film Jalsa.
To Film Jalsa.
Film Jalsa.
To Film Jalsa.
Film Jalsa.
Film Jalsa.
Film Jalsa channel.
To Film Jalsa.